Hello everyone, welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, area chart in Excel, watch the video till the end. And also, if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today we have a topic with us. It's called the area chart. It's basically a chart function which we are going to study. So let's begin with some of the basics before we directly jump on the example. Well, if we start with the area chart in Excel, selecting chart to show a graphical representation is basically very difficult. So if there is a lot of choices, it is very much important to select the correct chart type so that, you know, the results would be achieved or the aim would be achieved. It requires a lot of experience and, most importantly, I'll say the efforts to select the correct chart. Now, an area chart is basically a sort of a line chart which has one difference. The area which is below the line is filled with color, okay, and which makes it a little bit different. And an area chart in Excel, it is used to showcase what we sort call as the data, okay, which depicts the time series, okay. There is a relationship between the same, the time series relationship between the same has been explained there. Now, let me run you through what are exactly the uses of the area chart. Well, first, it is really useful when we have a different time series. If we say that when there are different time series data and we have to showcase the relation of each set to the whole data, then in that scenario it happens. The second, there are two axes. One is called the X and another is called the Y, where the information gets plotted in the area chart, and it is primarily used when the trend needs to be shown with the magnitude rather than the individual data values. Third, the series which have very fewer values are generally getting, you know, hide behind the series which have really high values. Now, this chart in Excel is of three types in both. It's called as 2D, and then there is a 3D chart, which an area are stacked. There are some charts called as the stacked chart, 100% stacked chart. And if we are using to display the series of different data, then, you know, there is a 3D chart any day available. Now, the next thing that we are going to learn is how to create an area chart in Excel. See, area chart is very simple and easy to use. Let's understand the working of the Excel area chart with some examples. Let's take example number one that is given here. 2010, 11, 12, 13 and 14 data with the cricket, hockey and football history given down here. And what we are going to do is we are going to run a chart here. So what we need to do here is go to the insert column. But before that, just select the whole thing. Go to the insert column. Then in the insert column, there is a thing called area. You can see map over here, open 3D maps. Okay. Over here, there are different charts like 2D column charts, 3D column charts, 2D bar and 3D bar. So you can select any of the one. Okay. So in here, we have to select one of the graph which is shown over here in the drop down list. And after clicking, you know, somewhat like this may appear. Okay. In any format, like let's take a 2D chart here. This one. So we'll get, you know, 2010 data, and you can keep changing, you know, how exactly you want the chart to be displayed. Look at this one. This looks really good. Okay. So it shows cricket and hockey and football, you know, how exactly things are there. So these are the basic steps which we have to follow to create an area chart in Excel. Now we'll take an example number two, which will be a stacked chart. Okay. Now, it is same as above one, just that we have to clip on 2D stacked or probably a 3D stacked. Okay, that's the only difference. Well, again, we'll go to the insert column and we'll go here. You can select the 2D chart. If you want a 3D chart, you can select a 3D chart. Okay, 3D bar chart if you want this type, you know, you can make it, right? So, this creates this kind of chart. And here the relation between the data and the year, which is of time relationship. And the overall trend of the games in the relation to the year. Then we have 100% stacked chart. You know, there is only difference is that all the values shown 100% the y-axis. So it helps in showing the better representation of the product lineup. Okay, so the only change in the creating 100% stack chart is to select the last option, the 2D or 3D like below. Something here. You know, the last option here. Okay. So this is how, you know, we can analyze the trend of the change in product bulb, fan consumptions, and the number of year. And hence we have seen the above example of the three types of the area in Excel, which helps us to understand more closely. It does not show the value-wise in the representation, but it shows the trends. Now, I want you to understand what are the variants of the Excel area chart. Variants of Excel area chart. Well, let's begin. See, that this chart can be shown in two ways. One is called the data plots, which overlaps each other. And there are data plots which are stacked on top of each other. So what are the pros and cons of this? Well, the pros over here, let's start with the pros first. First is a comparison of trend. Well, after looking at the area chart in Excel, it gives us a very clear understanding regarding the trend it is followed by in each product. Second is the comparison between small number of the category. Okay. So the stacked area is more easy to understand than the overlap. And though it surely takes more effort in reading than it took for a chart which has two categories. Third is the comparison between trends and not the values. So the overlap data is also readable and helpful by giving the colors and the appropriate values, right? Now let's understand the cons. Well, in case of the cons, the understanding goes as, you know, to deduce the values of the data of the plot. It should be read with respect to the previous plot from which we have to make comparison. And everyone is not used to it. Second, it is really difficult to analyze. Sometimes it's very much difficult to read the data and analyze to achieve the desired results. So those are the two things. So what are the points to remember in this particular regards? Well, first, the user, they must have a basic knowledge of chart to understand the chart. Okay. Second, the data should be compared with each other in relation to each time. Third, the basic understanding, very, very much needed. Basic understanding of the analyzing part of the chart. So, well, I hope you guys have got a fantastic idea regarding how the area chart works. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. I thank you, everyone. Cheers.